are now doing, this is number two.
Yeah, number two.
With our information series here. And tonight we got a couple different topics people are talking about. We're gonna hit them up. If you ever wanna talk about anything, just message us. We message the YouTube, well, message me. And if you know Richie's Instagram, what's your Instagram?
Richie_Morse. And if you write anything to me, I might not answer it, so you might as well write to him.
Exactly. So anyways, what's the supplement that we're supposed to talk about?
BioGrow.
Some stupid supplement, I guess.
Being banned.
Yeah, being banned, all that stuff. Anyways, what we read about it, there wasn't really any real information that I got out of it, yeah. Other than it has colostrum in it.
Yeah, that's why they're banning it, because they say...
Yeah, that's a joke. So colostrum is basically found in milk. And it's found in the first 3 days that a mother produces milk. And all it is a bunch of nutrients. What it contains is IGF-1 and growth factor 1. But if you take colostrum, you can't really absorb the IGF-1 because your stomach acids are going to break it down. It's basically useless. And it's been a supplement for years, putting different protein powders, and they charge extra money for it. To make you basically buy something that you don't even that doesn't even do anything. Some colostrums, I guess, people feel benefits from. Might be just placebo effect. Personally, I've taken colostrum. I didn't notice anything at all, and I've had real milk. I noticed more from milk than I did from colostrum. And I am a supplement advocate, except for most supplements. Like today, most supplements are owned by one big company and just sell you junk. So what's the other thing about the Arnold Classic?
Oh, the lineup. And the new, they're gonna have a new judgment basically upon like your actual routine. So like guys like, some guys are really stiff and can't like transition between poses, but then you got guys like that are smaller, but they don't get noticed because even though they have a good routine, it doesn't matter.
So let's just talk about that for 1 second. That's nothing new. They've said they've done this 1,000 times before. Anyone who's pretending this is new is one of them, one of the liars. This was done in the 80s. This was done in the 90s. This has never, ever gone through. They've never gone through with this stuff. Anytime a contest has been said they're going to judge the night show, nothing ever happens of it. Guys still get screwed. It's always happened. And they've done this many, many times. This is not the first time. Anyone who doesn't know anything about the history of bodybuilding obviously thinks this is a new idea, but anyone like myself who knows pretty much all the history of bodybuilding knows that this is a joke and that this has happened several times, and if they do anything, it's just going to make other people mad. Like Phil Heath, he's not a good poser.
No, he's horrible.
You got Kai Greene, who does this show. It's not really posing. It's more of like a show, and it's awesome because people enjoy it. Darren Charles, a guy you guys might not know, maybe you do. He does like a dance. You got Biggie Smalls. That's Freddie Smalls, who I competed against before. He's a great poser. He does the same type of things, like a dance routine, but he also is posing.
Yeah.
Someone was mentioning, I think Dave Palumbo was mentioning that Sean Ray and Flex Wheeler and Kevin Lavroni were good posers. Kevin Lavroni was the most, during one of the Olympias, he pulled out an American flag out of his underwear and posed to the national anthem. It was one of the worst posing routines in history. So I don't know why I throw Kevin's name. Sean Ray, another person who knows the history of bodybuilding. Good poser, terrible music. Terrible music. Flex Wheeler, excellent poser. Again, terrible music. If you're posing, and I don't want to be a jerk to people because everyone has their choice of music. But if you're posing to Celine Dion singing, or some other terrible women's music, basically. Yeah. If you're gonna pose to that, I don't see how that's art or even intelligent, because you're just literally making yourself look gay. Or personally,
they could be gay.
Gay for peg.
Yeah.
And basically make yourself not show your actual muscularity. Like Arnold said, you're a big guy, better pose to big music. And I was trained by Russ Testo, who was the same guy who trained Arnold in posing. That's why when I train people in posing, usually they had the best routines in the show. So, touching on that subject, I've never seen them go through with actually doing the posing round. Just like a long time ago, I think it was 2001, they had a round where the guys called out each other and picked a pose. And Ronnie Coleman screwed up. He picked a pose he lost to. And then he won all of a sudden to it. And I remember that one because Jay Cutler didn't like that. And I remember that I think Gustavo Bodell ended up finishing third and Dexter Jackson was in third but got fourth due to that. And then they got rid of it. It was cool to see it, but they got rid of it. And now you guys have the internet, so usually you can look at this stuff and look up all these crazy things that happened, but they're not going to show you the 1981 Mr. Olympia. Because that was a blunder. Even though Franco Colombo was my favorite out of all bodybuilders, pretty much. So, let's quit the bodybuilding for a second and just hit on another subject. Any kid out there that's eating soy, gotta tell you again, kids, stop eating soy. It's junk. Do not eat soy. I was screaming at some guy on Instagram today, some vegan guy.
Oh, God.
I asked him if he liked soy. He's like, oh, yeah, I love soy. I was like, yeah, well, you know, chills. Avoid soy at all costs. 99% of soy is definitely GMO. That's proven. And you don't want anything GMO right now because you don't know what the hell it's going to do to your body. And they also have the well, we already talked about it. So if you don't know, go back to the last one and you can understand why I'm talking about not eating soy.
You got to let them know about the fast food meat too.
Yeah, if you don't know, you know, now you know. All fast food meat is 76 to like 56% soy meat. There's no real meat.
Yeah.
There's actually like 3% beef in a burger at McDonald's. Same with like Burger King, Wendy's. They're all within like a range of 3 to 15%. And if you haven't seen Super Size Me, I suggest you buy that movie or watch it, rent it, Netflix, YouTube is probably on there. Those are great ways to look. You shouldn't be eating fast food, period. You shouldn't be eating it at all. It's not, I'm gonna carb up, I'm gonna bulk up. It's not bulking season. It's not dirty bulk and all these stupid things that people made up that we used to call back in the day. You're either fat or you're in shape. Because you're bulking, they would just call you fat, to be honest. And I was one of the people who did that to people because I was constantly in shape, constantly. So, yeah, don't go eat fast food. And honestly, there's so much we can do on nutrition, but I do this for my living. If you want, you know, if you want to actually get deep into it, I can explain how everything that you're eating is probably contaminated. And everything you're eating might contain soy, including your fresh chicken that you're buying. That's been injected with a soy glycerin mixture to make it weigh more. That's why when you cook it, it gets real small. There's a bunch of water in the George Foreman. That's what that is, guys. It says it right on the packaging of most places, like Purdue Chicken. Just look at the fine print. It's right on there. So the next show that we do, I'm going to teach people how to read a nutrition label.
Yeah.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know how.
We just want to hit on subjects to get more people watching this. So if you have a subject that's hot, new topic, throw it at us. I'll tell you how old the topic really is. I've read every single book ever written on weightlifting, bodybuilding, powerlifting, strongman, lifting weights in general, and health. I have books, basically have a library, stuff from like 1800s all the way up to current day. I've read it. I pretty much have seen everything. And there are concepts that are back then, were new, and they're being called new today, just like your colostrum. That was, I think it came out in 1970s. Joe Weider product.
I just got to go back to the Arnold Classic with a question of how you think Cody Montgomery